Hey everyone, Claire here from My Mortgage. Today I just wanted to talk a little bit about whether or not you need to wait until you've got 20% deposit to buy your first home. This is a question I get quite a bit. A lot of people come to me with 10% deposit made up of some KiwiSaver, potentially the first home grant and some savings and maybe a gift from mum and dad. And they say, look, should we just keep saving? Should we see if we can get to 20%? Well, there are a couple of different elements to this, and the main one is how long is that going to take you? And the answer to it is probably a reasonable amount of time. And at the moment, we're in a pretty strong borrowing environment where most banks are still giving people with 10% deposit rates in the late threes and early fours, which isn't too bad depending on how much you're borrowing. So, what you need to consider is how long is it going to take you to get to 20%, and is it going to be better for you actually to get on the ladder before that to allow you to build some equity in your property? The disadvantages are definitely that it is going to cost you a little bit more. Across the board, it's around about 0.75 to 1% difference in mortgage repayments weekly, fortnightly, monthly. And there's also a couple of other things you need to bear in mind, like that you need to have really good credit, you need to have low existing debt, and you also need to get a registered valuation, which is a little bit of a cost as well. Overall, though, you might pay, depending on how much you borrow, somewhere between $5,000 and $10,000 more a year. And usually, properties in the last 5 to 10 years have gone up by more than $5,000 or $10,000 a year, which means that you are probably going to be in a slightly better position in a year's time if you do just use your 10% deposit. Banks are a little bit stricter in this space. So, as I mentioned before, you will need to tick a couple of extra boxes. But generally, if you are two people working and you've got good income, not a lot of personal existing debt, and a 10% deposit made up of KiwiSaver and some savings, it's definitely worth seeing if it's a good time for you to buy. And I'm more than happy to go through those numbers with you and make sure you understand what your pros and cons are for doing that. So get in touch with me. My name is Claire, and my email address is claire@mymortgage.co.nz. Even easier, pop onto our website and go through our contact us page, and myself or Greg will come back to you as soon as possible. Look forward to helping you with your first home.